Let me give a shout out to my homegirl and my YouTube sister, Nikki J Beauty. Happy birthday, boo. Now, y'all, let me get dressed because I'm not rushing. Not quite yet. I sound like Jasmine, don't I? I did. Anywho, I need to get dressed, but y'all, this is my new do-rag. My husband hate is a strong word. He hates the regular do-rag, so I got me something just so appease this man, because he be like, that look like a dude, it is a dude do-rag, but I didn't know do-rags had gender. Now, that'd be something if we see a brother walking around with a damn bonnet on his head, right? I will cuss his ass out, too. Straight up. Let's just keep it 100. Bonnets ain't made for no damn body. Unless your ass got curly hair and you is going to bed. But there are even ways to put your hair up and still be cute. It's called a pineapple. So, I have 45 minutes to get dressed, and y'all are gonna see the new color after I beat this face. Okay, I'll see you.
Good morning. Good morning. She looks at me and goes, I hate you. I am loving it. I'm so glad I decided to go back. Okay. Give me about two more processes and it will be white platinum blonde like it was last time. Okay.
Oh my god, like, is this Peyton? Is this like the new and improved Peyton? Like, somebody tell me. Y'all know Tay Tay is feeling real cute, but I'm gonna be feeling real cute after I get this haircut. This is what you do when you're waiting on your employees to get to work. You play with Snapchat filters. Hey!
So, baby! Woo! I'm feeling juicy.
Cousin
talking about she feel juicy. Like, what the hell does that mean? Do that mean you feel swole?
Child, that bitch means she feels swole. That's what it means. Juicy is another word for saying my ass feel fat. Motherfucker.
Did that angry heifer just call me fat? Bitch, why you look so mad?
No, she did not come for my entire life talking about, bitch, why you look mad. Bitch, look at your neck.
What is up with you, my guy? My family is, like, off the chain, like, too early this morning. Tay-Tay, no, just not. Now, one of them heifers better come for me, because I will fuck you up. Y'all, Tay-Tay's getting real hungry. 2:30, can't get here faster than enough. Do you feel me?
Alright, y'all. Do we like these? Are we feeling these? Like,
Y'all know I keeps my eyewear, my eye candy on fleek, okay? Some of y'all were asking me about those clear glasses that I got. And Charlotte Russe got some that's all clear too. $6.
Y'all, I never came back because y'all, I got caught up and I had to get to work, okay? So now that I have made it to work, it is now almost 2:30 and I'm about to go get some lunch. And then when I come back, I'll chit chat with y'all for a little while because y'all, I'm hungry like a hostage. Do you feel me? Hungry. So, I will see y'all when I get back, okay? I was a horrible, horrible vlogger at this moment, okay? I'm charging my phone. I didn't even eat all my lunch. Because I'm trying to order my Mother's Day stuff for my mama's. My mama, mama, y'all know. Oh, but now I gotta go back on the floor, so y'all will talk when I get off work. I've just been a busy little bee today, okay? Okay. All right, y'all. There has been a little change of plan for me because y'all know I packed my stuff for the gym and my gym partner actually had to be called in to work today because one of the managers had to call out because she was sick, but everybody that she could call was already working today. Oh my god, y'all, when these tourists come in and they shopping, y'all, shit be all over the flow. People act like they don't know how to hang up stuff. It just be like, how do you keep your house? Like, you do this at home? I'm gonna go ahead and answer that. Yep, they do. But it just makes me a little bit more cautious when I'm in the role of a customer because, granted, I ain't gonna lie, y'all, all the years that I stayed out of retail, and it was about a 4-year break, even though my business is retail, ain't that funny? Not being like in a mall type atmosphere, y'all, that's the part I did not miss, okay? People just don't treat your space with respect. And I'm a firm believer in that you gotta teach your customers how to treat your establishment. Granted, y'all, one day when Eclectic Nista has a brick and mortar building, and I'm gonna have a consignment shop, y'all, most definitely. And I told y'all, Eclectic Nista is all about a lifestyle, too. So, you know, lifestyle coaching, you know, stylist on duty, but also be able to shop and consign with my consumer. Come on, man, with your little car. Oh, so you teach your customers how to treat your establishment. If your establishment is clean, tidy, and you keep it up, they will treat your establishment with respect. Now, like I just said, y'all, we be having tourists, foreigners, people from other countries, and a lot of them don't talk English. So it's like, I don't know if it's their custom where they're from, that when you go in the fitting room to try clothes on, you just leave it on the floor, like you don't hang it back up, like, man, you didn't find that on the floor like that. You feel me? Like, So it's a habit, y'all, that when I'm working and if I put you in the fitting room, best believe I'm gonna tell you when I put you in there, when you come out, could you bring everything out with you? I'm not afraid to have dialogue, okay? Especially with minors when they shopping. And y'all, I'm so excited. I asked a group of girls that came in the store today,
because y'all know Jada's Sweet 16 is next month. And unfortunately, what I always envisioned in my head to do for Jada when she turned 16, unfortunately, that cannot happen. Because y'all already know, she ain't been on a straight and narrow, and I told y'all, I don't reward mediocre, okay? Nah. But, however, she has shown improvement over the past month. Key is maintenance, right? Consistency. And I still want her Sweet 16 to be very memorable. So I have an idea of what I'm going to do for her Sweet 16, and it is only going to involve me and her. Because when Jasmine turned 16, Jasmine was not feeling Jada cock blocking on her special day. So I'm not gonna let Jazz cock block on Jada's special day, okay? But what I have in mind, these teenagers I was talking to today, they made me feel like, oh yeah, that's the bomb birthday gift. The bomb. I can't tell y'all right now because y'all know Jada be watching these vlogs. But what I wanted to do with her, what I did with Jazz, when Jazz turned 16, I took Jazz to, Jasmine literally had a girl's night out. Like, they thought they was grown, y'all. A girl's night out in Atlanta. And basically, I let her invite, I think, 5 or 6 friends. And basically, like I said, girl's night out. You know, you go out to the club, you get your girls, everybody looking fly, everybody, like, all cute and ish, right? Yeah, that's how it was. Parents dropped the kids off at my house. Jasmine's friends, I knew all of her friends, parents. And this is, like I said, y'all, this is when we lived in Atlanta. Girl took them to College Park. We went to College Park and I dropped them off at the teen club, Cascades. Y'all know that y'all seen the movie ATL? Well, it turns into a teenager nightclub on Saturday night. They had like a teen club area in there. And I dropped them off. Yes, I walked in. Me and D, we walked in. And we just had to scope it out. And we just had to let them know. When they close, I ain't coming to look for nobody. Y'all butts better be out here waiting for me, okay? Me and D dropped the girls off. We went and we had dinner. We had our own girls' night out. I took my daughter for Sweet 16. Earlier that day, I had reserved a suite, an adjoining suite at the Westin in Midtown Atlanta. And if y'all, any of y'all are from Atlanta, y'all know the Westin in Midtown, the W. That hotel is freaking fabulous, okay? When I tell y'all so many photo ops for in that doggone hotel, gorgeous, okay? I went there earlier that day. I decorated the suite all nice. I mean, when I tell y'all, it was fancy. It was fancy. Clearly for them, because yeah, they had a 4-star hotel, okay? I created, I bought all her friends little margarita glasses. I had like virgin margarita mix and all that stuff ready for them. Each girl got an Asian, y'all know, like the Chinese food box, you know, the little box. Each girl had a colored box with her name on it and like all the stuff that you could do for a sleepover. Nails, makeup, stuff for pedicures, face mask, you name it. The box was filled, okay? Had confetti and balloons all over the place for them. It was like, Jasmine was like, they was feeling like they was some VIP, okay? They was. Like, she was feeling like she was, like, the elite. Alright, child, picked them up. Everybody was on time. I didn't have to scold nobody or nothing. Everybody was on time. It was late, so we did a Krispy Kreme run. All the girls got the McDonald's. We went and checked into the hotel. Y'all, me and Dee was in the adjoining room, which the door was left open, but I let them have their privacy. And when I tell y'all, like, they sang happy birthday to her. I had her cake in there. made them their drinks. They did karaoke. They danced. They opened her presents and stuff like that. Y'all, let me just tell you this. They didn't go to sleep until like 5-6 o'clock the next morning. And then to make sure that Mr. Long was involved in Jazz's Sweet 16, he came and he picked up all the girls from the W, picked them all up, and he took Jasmine and all her friends to Raise on the River. When I tell y'all, if you live in Atlanta, y'all know Raise on the River, the one, I believe it's in Sandy Springs, or it's like in that Marietta area, but it's off the river. For the Sunday brunch, y'all, bill was like $400 and something, okay? But memorable moment for her to hang with her friends, her to spend part of her Sweet 16 with her mother, and the other part she spent with her father. Now, Jada was not cock blocking because Jasmine was not trying to hear all of that, y'all. So Jada had to hang with me. She was with her daddy when I was with Jasmine. And then she was with her daddy. She was with me when Jasmine was with her daddy. And then they all went to the mall. He took all the girls to the mall. They went shopping. And then that was her little girl's night out weekend. And it was, I really wanted to do the same thing for Jada. Probably with a twist, because clearly we don't live in Atlanta anymore. But hopefully, y'all, she get her stuff all the way together when she turns 17 next year. It's like gonna be like a do-over, a Sweet 17. And some people be like, oh, Steph, you should still go out. No, you have to earn what it is that you feel that you deserve. And the other surprise that I have planned for her is just as sweet. It's just as sweet. It's just not going to involve a group of girls and a suite. It's not going to involve those things. So I got to run about her daddy first. That's why I can't tell y'all. I got to run about her dad first. And I just had a bright idea this morning on my way to work. So, y'all have arrived at the barber shop. So let me get in here, get myself taped up, cleaned up, fresh to death for Mother's Day. And I'll see y'all later.
Good morning, y'all. It's Friday. Friday morning. And I am getting up. For real now, and my memory card is blinking. I have 0 minutes. I'm back. I had to delete some memory, okay? Oh my God. Oh my God. Thank you, Father, for waking me up this morning. Oh, Lord, thank you, thank you, thank you. So, it's time to get up. Time to get fabulous. Today, I'm going to work, and after work, we're gonna have a girls happy hour when I get off. Me and my home girl, Michelle. Now, y'all, Michelle is one of my co-workers at work, and told y'all, I'm a social butterfly. I am. So, we both have daughters around the same age. Her daughter is still in college, and she attends FIT in New York. And she is, I know, in the arts field. And she is an artist, and she is sensitive about her shit, okay? She's an artist, and I think she's in her junior year, getting ready to become a senior. And when I tell y'all, like, we both have so much in common. The only thing that we don't have in common currently is I'm married and she is previously divorced. However, she does have 2 children and she's a little bit older than me, but she's still in her 40s. And we just from day one, y'all, when like I went through orientation, when I tell y'all, I could just tell like she is a New York girl to the bone. We just click. And just how I be talking to y'all. Y'all just how I be talking to her. I do. She good people. Really, really good people. And I don't know. Sometimes, like I say, God put people in your life for a reason and a certain time. And when I met this whole staff, y'all, that I work with, when I met them when I started last July, she called me an ass the other day because I told her, I said, really, I didn't plan on staying at Charlotte Russe after December. Y'all remember, I had started this job to assist with a vacation package that I wanted to do for Jazz for graduation. Well, after, you know, they had the hurricane and stuff in the Dominican and Haiti and all of that, plans got changed. But I told her, I said, I had only planned on being there through December and January. I was about to chuck them deuces. I told her, I said, however, I enjoy the people I work with. It's no drama. It's everybody in there is like just free. And I'm gonna tell y'all, it's a difference up north in the work environment versus down south. Cause y'all, like, we be so straight up, ain't no sugarcoating. Even our management team, like when we have managers meet in, like, you say how you feel and mean what you say, you know what I'm saying? And it's just an open forum like that. Like, I can appreciate working with a group of women, y'all. Y'all know sometimes it's hard for us to work as a group, united, you know what I'm saying? And we have really good chemistry, me and her. And so today, since we are working pretty much kind of like the same schedule, I'm a mid, she's opening. When we both get off this evening, we are both gonna go have a happy hour. So I'm looking forward to that because this would be the first time I hang out with her outside of the Russe, okay? So she's gonna let her hair down, even though she already always let her hair down. But I'm gonna let my blonde glow, and we gonna have some genuine grown folk, grown woman time. Y'all, you can have your BFFs, your best friends, and I don't ever use that term like lightly, because I don't call every woman I meet my friend, you know what I'm saying? Because every woman you meet ain't necessarily for you, you feel me? Clearly, y'all better have learned something from Real Housewives of Atlanta with Phaedra and Candy. That was just totally jacked up right there. But it's, you can't be calling everybody your friend. Just, that's plain and simple. And she is someone that I literally consider to be a friend. And I told her the only reason I stayed was because I enjoy working with all of them. She said, Steph, you're such an ass. She was like, really, you was gonna leave in January? Yeah, that was the plan. I was. But I told her, because of them, because I enjoy who I work with, that's why I'm still there, y'all. It's social time for me, you know, because even being an entrepreneur, you know, in the field that I'm in, y'all know I love my fashion, okay? My fashion, my beauty, my whole eclectic Nista self. That's why I am Eclectnista. Y'all better go follow me on Instagram. If you don't, child, you will get your dose of everyday flyness, okay? I haven't been posting like I used to, but I'm back on that. I'm back on it. Because y'all be hitting me up in my DMs talking about, girl, why you stop posting outfits of the day? I be slipping and slacking sometime, but I'm back on my ish. I am. So, back to friends. Friends come a dime a dozen, but all women, we need female companionship. Or do we? Great question to start off. Do you feel like you need female companionship? Trust, my husband gonna always be numero uno. I love James. Y'all already know that. And he is my best friend for life. I married my best friend. He sleeps right there, okay? However, my husband does understand that I need female companionship. I like to go out. I like to have girl time. I like to have shopping adventures. I like going to get my nails done with my friends. You know, I like going, you know, to dinner, to lunch. You know, I love it all, y'all, because I am really a girl type of girl. You feel me? And I just like to have fun, enjoy myself, enjoy the company that I'm around. And word on the block, y'all, my friends enjoy me too. Sometimes I think they enjoy me a little too much. But that's a good thing. That just means I'm loved. And I have my BFFs that don't live in my local area. They live currently in Texas, in Atlanta. However, I need friendship around me as well. And so, that's why I am venturing out today. And I'm looking so forward to our girls' night. Well, not girls' night out. Our girls' happy hour. Hey! So, let me go get cute so I can be cute for this when I get off. But I'm definitely going to dress appropriately today because bipolar weather again in Jersey. Here we go. Y'all shouldn't be surprised by that.
Good morning, y'all, from Peyton. I just wanted to say hello, you know, before all these people get up and start coming for y'all. You know, I'm not the ratchet one, you know, I'm the soft-spoken, you know, just being tiny, cute little me. It is too motherfucking early for that big-eyed heifer to be talking about she ain't ratchet. Tim Steff tell y'all ass earlier this week, perfection is an illusion. All I'm gonna say is Peyton is delusional. How about that? Don't try me, bitch. It's too motherfucking early. Peyton must not know. I'm from slap a bitch, snatch a bitch, grab a bitch tribe, okay?
Y'all, I am not even getting in that shit right there. You know what I'm saying? Because if anything, I got my money on Tay-Tay. Y'all know Tay-Tay told us yesterday, me and the angry one told us not to come for her. That's why y'all don't see the angry one today. Bitch went missing.
Do Tay-Tay look
fazed?
No. She looks fazed. But she will learn real quick today. Okay. So in the spirit of it being Friday, good morning, y'all. Let's get cute.
Girl, you ever feel that when you got on high heels and you be walking, you just be feeling like your booty is like, oh, it's following you? Heels to Vans, because honey, ain't nobody gonna be walking through the store with no high heels on. Not I, no ma'am.
Okay, Tay-Tay got a question. Like, this dude was in the store and he was reeking of weed. And I'm just wondering, like, is it possible that you can get high off just smelling somebody that reeks of weed? Cause honey, it was strong. Did y'all hear me? Tay-Tay said that shit was strong.
All right, y'all. I'm off work, and now I'm getting ready to go have our little happy hour. Our girl happy hour. Hey, that's what we about to have. She went to go get her some cigarettes. And y'all know I don't smoke. But she's supposed to meet me over here. And
I want y'all to meet Michelle. I hope she ain't camera shy. I don't know, she might be. Let's see. I know people be looking at you crazy when you're vlogging because they don't understand it. Okay, who does that? Me. All right, y'all, let me find her. See where she at. She might already be in here. Girl is back. I made it home, y'all, around about 10 o'clock, 10:16, somewhere around there. And y'all, Michelle is not quite ready for this vlogging. I was trying to get her, but she was like, Steph, let me ease into it. I'm a lot of ease into it, y'all. But I really wanted y'all to meet her tonight. And she just wasn't ready for the camera. Beautiful woman, though. Anywho, we met at 6. We had drinks, we had food, we had fellowship, we had great, great, great conversation, great girl talk, and we just really have a whole lot in common. So I guess y'all can understand how our shifts at work are. We are talking, but we be working too, you know what I'm saying? And it was just nice to have a grown woman conversation outside of the workplace. And we both said that we must continue to do this because every girl needs a girl's happy hour. You feel me? Every girl needs that in her life. And you know what? It's called, we all need our female companionship, y'all. We talked about marriage, we talked about our kids, we talked about work, we talked about 9/11 because Michelle is from Staten Island, New York. We just talked about a lot. And y'all, when you don't have your phone, not even on the table, like it was in my purse, and y'all just talking and don't even know what time it is, ain't nobody looked at a clock or watch, you know what I'm saying? That's when you know you are enjoying your company. So on that note, y'all, I'm about to go get in the shower. I'm about to go shave my legs because in the morning I'm going to work out. I need to go get my feet and my nails done because tomorrow night I am doing the dun 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 dun. I missed a long vlog it. I don't know if y'all want to see me in all this agony and pain, but I'm also getting this tattoo on my shoulder. I'm also getting this refreshed in the one in the small of my back. My tramp stamp. And y'all, I'm only a tramp for my husband when need be. Sometimes you have to bring out those thought tendencies, you know, when you with your man, your husband, okay? You must let them know. You can be whoever he needs you to be, okay? Okay, and on that note, y'all, speaking of being who he need me to be, he need me upstairs right now. Because y'all, he was missing me. So tomorrow is his time to be with me before I spend time with the whole family on Sunday. I hope all of you mothers out there, I hope you all have a happy Mother's Day this Sunday. And if you don't speak to your girl before Sunday, just know this. I love y'all and y'all strive to be the best that y'all can be. We do not just wear the title of wife, mother, girlfriend, sister, aunt. We wear the biggest title that God gave us, and that is woman. Okay? Woman. Woman. Okay, women, I love y'all. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, turn your notifications on, and I will see y'all in the next vlog. Good night.